5-3. I gave him the second 5-4. Williams, the next two rounds, 5-4.
Scoring done by Rounds.
Rounds got a 2-2.
Yes. The supplemental five-point must system is used in the event of a draw. So that, as far as Randy Gordon is concerned, may be of consequence. Scheduled for 10. This is round number 5. Carl the Truth Williams on the left. James Quick Tillis on the right.
And now we're starting to see more of that long truth jab.
85 inches is the jab, but if we then take a look at it, at the Randy reach, which is really the true.
It really is. The other reach is the wingspan. When I take a Randy's reach, I take it, I have him hold their jabbing arm out, and I take the tape measure from the chin to the middle knuckle.
And there is Williams with a combination. No, says Williams, and he comes back with a jab. Well, how long is that jab of Williams from the chin to the jabbing knuckle?
33 inches, the longest jab in boxing. And he's whooping it up. You can hear him whooping it up with every punch he lands. As the rounds are going on, Williams is getting more and more into this fight. And you know something? We have hardly seen his right hand. It is devastating.
Tillis has won 7 of his last 8 fights. Since his loss to Greg Page back in November of 82, 2 years ago.
And I've got to start wondering, is Tillis running out of gas or getting hurt? Because he's not throwing punches with anger. Now he's going defensively, and Williams is opening up.
Williams pushing Tillis.
I got a feel that those 223¼ pounds Williams is carrying around is a bit too much baggage. I really think he can shed about 6 or 7 pounds and not be weakened. In fact, be stronger and quicker by it.
Well, Williams has erased in his mind the first round, which he was down twice. There is some swelling under the right eye of Williams. Tillis bringing Smoger into the picture.
I'm telling you, Williams is having fun. And the first round was not fun for him. Since then, it's been fun.
Referee did not even warn Tillis for holding on behind the net. 15 seconds to go in the 5th round. As they embrace, as this round comes to an end. 5 gone, perhaps 5 to go.
I doubt it.
Two heavyweights ranked in the top 20. Carl Williams, number 16 in the world, undefeated. 15 fights, he has won 12 of those by knockout. And he has rebounded from a first round almost to destruction. James Tillis, 30-4, we have him now as his official record, 23 knockouts. And he is ranked number 19 by the WBC.
There you see the fast hands of Carl the Truth Williams. He's now starting to really put his punches together.
Well, Tillis has been on the end of early knockdowns. He was knocked down by Ernie Shavers, came back to beat Shavers in a decision in 10 rounds. He knocked down Greg Page early. Page came back.
Knocked down against Shavers. I was at ringside for that fight. He almost went through the canvas.
And in the Page fight, with Page down, he came back and beat Tillis. Right now, Carl Williams will try to duplicate that scenario. Round number 6. Williams taking over the fight here in the middle round.
The confidence in James Tillis' eyes, I believe, is fading. And now it looks like it's turning to fear. There's no more snap on those punches. They're almost defensive kind of punches to keep Williams away. Williams is owning this fight at this point. Dominating.
6'4", 223 and a quarter pounds is Williams, reaching out again with the jab. Tillis, 6'2 and a half, 211 and a quarter. A big man himself, but lost there in that picture behind Carl Williams.
Well, we have learned a lot about Carl Williams tonight. Of course, the fight could be far from over. But he was really rocked in the first round as he went down twice and has been coming back stronger and stronger.
This is Williams' 16th fight. This is the third furthest he has gone. And he is backing Tillis, but Tillis snaps in the right, and Williams again shakes. No, no problem. There's another right by Tillis. As Williams falling right into it.
I'm telling you, whenever Williams gets hit, and those who are right hands that were dropped on his chin, he just comes in and you hear him going, woo!
The left jab sets it up for Williams. 1 minute left in the sixth round.
There he goes again with the woo. He's having fun. Look where the left hand is, though. Tillis has got to stop moving and fire that right hand. Well, it's his only hope.
Randy, you're talking about the quickness in the hands of Tillis. Why hasn't he been able to get that right up? He's got the inviting target.
Well, after he knocked Carl the Truth Williams down in round one, he also round on my scorecard, Tillis won the second round. When he saw Williams starting to get stronger in the third, I think he started to lose heart.
Well, he appears as if he is tiring somewhat, although coming into the fight, you're talking about what great condition Tillis is in.
I believe a good shot is going to put Tillis down.
10 seconds to go in this sixth. The Truth went down in the first, and Quick Tillis paying the consequences ever since.
And you're still not seeing the real short Williams jab. When he watches the tape back, he's going to see where that left hand is. He'll start picking it up from here on in, every fight from now on. I got to give matchmaker Ron Katz a lot of credit for putting this kind of world-class match together. One of the bright young faces in the game.
Williams ranked number 16. Tillis ranked number 19. But at this point, they may be going in opposite directions. Tillis ranked way up there a couple of years ago, getting a WBA title shot against Mike Weaver. Losing in 15 rounds, although there are many who did not see it that way. Thought that Tillis should have been crowned the champion.
And I thought in September of 1983, in Richfield, Ohio, it was the night that Michael Dokes was knocked out by Hedy Kutsia. Tillis lost on a first-round knockout to terrible Tim Witherspoon. He actually slipped in the corner as he was going down. Witherspoon teed off on him. The fight was over in the first.
A big left by Williams. Tillis off the ropes. Williams trying to get in with the right, but it's parried nicely by Tillis. There's the right by Tillis as the bell sounds, and now blood out of the nose of James Quick Tillis, but he got in the right at the bell, ending round number seven. Now we had no calls from Williams as he went into the corner at the end of the seventh round and taking that right by Tillis. As we are backed in, you are right on the scene. It is Williams stalking Tillis.
Carl Williams is just getting stronger and stronger and growing in confidence. Tillis is going to have to do something to get back into this fight, like stand there and just fight back with Williams and hurt him again.
And there's the right by Tillis. Always explosive, and Williams should know that by now. Can't get too cocky. You see Williams rise up to his feet, and Tillis, it appeared to be somewhat of a chore. Round number eight.
I once was sitting at the Phil Forum in Madison Square Garden in New York at ringside with Carl the Truth Williams. A fan came over to him and said, LeVar, would you sign this? A lot of people think he's LeVar Burton, a lookalike. The actor you know from Roots.
Obviously, Williams was sitting down.
Obviously, he really does look like LeVar.
Round number 8. Williams on the right, Tillis on the left. There's the wave by Tillis again.
And it hurt Williams. You saw his legs do a Mr. Bojangles.
And now Williams keeping some distance. Randy Gordon has Tillis winning the first 2 rounds, but it has been all Williams since then, coming back to take the last 5. That according to Randy Gordon, our unofficial judge. So Tillis getting in a couple of good rights, one to end the 7th round and one here, so he has pepped up a little bit. He has come to life.
Well, I would not call Quint Tillis a marvelous Marvin Hagler of the heavyweights, because when Hagler hurts you, you're gone, you're out of there. Larry Holmes is the same way. Tillis has hurt his man in the first round really bad, and he hurt him a few moments ago with that right hand, doing nothing about it.
Now, some fighters may be embarrassed, missed with the right, as Williams ducked under it. Some fighters may be embarrassed about being knocked down, especially Williams coming in, has not hit the canvas, going down twice. But when you start building towards a championship, the questions are, has he ever come back from a knockdown? Well, Williams proving that tonight.
Very important fight in the career of Carl Williams tonight. But it's not over.
Ninth or 8th round action. Well, under a minute to go.
I really think Williams is making this a tougher fight than he has to, because with that long reach, that 33-inch reach to 30 for Tillis, that's a 3-inch reach advantage, Williams should be standing on the outside and jabbing all night long.
Well, do you think Tillis should be moving it on the inside?
He should be trying it. Carl Williams is not really keeping his distance the way he should, though, and Tillis is not taking advantage of it. Should be banging the body.
Under 30 seconds. Tillis trying to keep the distance, though, from that long jab. Get away from that jab. Williams could be in the center of the ring. Tillis may have to stand in the corner. And that's the end of round number 8. Tillis, the veteran, he has seen 9-10 rounds on many occasions. 6 times into a 10th round, and then they had won the 15-rounder against Weaver. As far as Williams is concerned, the longest he has gone once, 10 rounds, winning a decision against Woody Clark last year. And now he is the second longest fight of his young career, heading into the 9th round.
Carl Williams being told in his corner, only 9 and 10, this is your fight, do it.
And Williams is ready, barking out again. Tillis taking the time. Taking the deep breath. 211 and a quarter pounds, stepping in against the bigger Williams, who's 223 and a quarter. Al Albert along with Randy Gordon at ringside at the Atlantis Casino Hotel in Atlantic City, New Jersey.
Williams did the right thing that time. As soon as the bell rang, he moved across the ring, and he didn't stick out a lazy left jab. He really fired a couple of left jabs at Tillis.
Coming up, our main event, heavyweights Marvis Frazier against Bernard Bull Benton. The right, the left by Williams.
And you know what? I think that fight is going to be more exciting than this fight. And this has been plenty exciting. Carl Williams got hurt for a moment, and he was lucky that he was able to fall into a clinch. A real good right hand by Tillis. He just doesn't use it enough. Ooh, he started to commit himself and walked into a jab.
Williams continues. continues to talk to Tillis. There's the quick snapping jab. Tillis' head responds.
A slight swelling on the side and underneath the right eye of Carl the Truth Williams. A lot of left hands have landed there tonight.
Midway through the ninth round.
Well, Carl the Truth Williams, the new breed of heavyweight, goes over 220 pounds. Bone Crusher Smith, 230. Larry Holmes now fighting at around 225. Jerry Cooney, 230. Of course, the heaviest of them all, I guess it'd have to be James Broad, who goes anywhere from 250 to about 1,000 pounds.
Depends on when he is weighed. Before or after a meal. Now, when will there be a super heavyweight division?
If Broad wins the title.
Well, we talk about Frazier and Ben coming up. The heavyweights, they're basically on the border between the cruiserweight and the heavyweight division.
Marvis Frazier still believes he can climb in the ring with big guys like this, and he already beat James Broad. He outboxed him, and hey, that's the name of the game.
Under 30 seconds in round number 9. It's scheduled for 10. Well, referee Steve Smoger breaking them up. He certainly has two fighters he could look up to tonight in the ring. Williams 6'4", and Tillis at 6'2.5". Final seconds of round 9. We will go to a 10th and final round here in Atlantic City. As you notice, the gate back to the corners now, slowing down considerably. 3 minutes to go. The end swell applied underneath the left eye of Tillis.
That being applied by one of the best cutmen in the business from Blackwood, New Jersey, Ralph Citro. Gonna take a look at some action from round number 9. There's a lead left hook by Carl the Truth Williams that sends Tillis back towards the rope. Tillis should really come back with some punches of his own, but he just keeps moving. And the more he moves, and the more he moves away from Williams, he's giving this fight away.
Coming up, our main event, 10-round heavyweight bout, Marvis Frazier stepping in against Bull Bernard Benton. He says he doesn't want to be called football, just Bull. A bull in a china shop.
Everything.
Coming up next in our main event, going up against Marvis Frazier. But first, concluding matters here. They touch gloves, signifying the final round. 10th round. It is Quick Tillis on the left, Carl Williams on the right. There have been two knockdowns in this fight, as Carl Williams was dropped by Tillis twice in the first round. But Williams responding extremely well. He has dominated the fight since. Well, Randy Gordon gave Tillis that second round, but since that time, Randy has given Williams every round.
For a moment there, you just saw Carl Williams get stunned. I'm not going to say staggered.